Good morning, dear students. Welcome to Maths class. I hope all of you are fine and healthy. Due to the pandemic disease COVID-19, we are not unable to take the regular classes. So now I am doing recorded class. The first chapter of 7th class is integers. So what is integers? Integers are the numbers. In your earlier classes you might have studied what is the meaning of numbers, isn't it? Numbers are used to count the things. So there are different kinds of numbers. The first set is called as natural numbers. It is denoted by n. So it is denoted by n. N means natural numbers. It is also called as counting numbers. The numbers we will use 1, 2, 3, 4, that means it continues. You are not having time to write. Okay. So this set of numbers is called as natural numbers, denoted by n. The next set of number is called as whole numbers, denoted by W. It consists of whole. It is same as natural number, but one number is extra, that is zero. Zero along with natural numbers are called as whole numbers. Zero along with natural numbers are called as whole numbers. This is what? Natural numbers. All the positive numbers are called as natural numbers. Zero and positive numbers are called as whole numbers. Now, the next one is called as integers. The name may be different. It indicates natural number. It is whole number. It is not like that. But it is also a number. Integers. Integer. Denoted by Z. What do you mean by Z? Z is an integer. It consists of 0, 1, 2, 3, that. Along with this, it also consists of negative numbers, that is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Like this, it continues. Infinite numbers are there, you know, isn't it? So, 0 along with positive and negative natural numbers are called as integers, denoted by Z. So, the topic is integers. In this chapter, we are going to learn different concepts. Shortly, I will revise that. Already, you have taken the notes. So then, now I will revise the concept one by one. So, the introduction of the chapter is, what is the meaning of integers? Integers are numbers, consists of zero, positive numbers and negative numbers. Now, the concept is number line. What do you mean by number line? Word is clear now. What do you mean by number line? Number line is a line which consists of numbers. That is, at the center 0. When you move right towards, you will get plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. Like this continues. When you come back to the left side, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Understood? Number line is a line which consists of numbers. Which are the numbers? At the center, 0. When you move rightwards, you will get positive numbers. When you move leftwards, you will get negative numbers. It is also called as integers. Representation of integers on a line is called as number line. Representation of integers on a line. Representation of integers on a line is called as number line. So number line consists of zero, positive numbers and negative numbers. The next one is operations of integers. What do you mean by operations? Operations of integers. Along with me, we have to go through the notes also. Every points I have given in detail. While watching this class, we have to go through the notes. The points which I have covered in notes, now I will recall. So what is the meaning of operations of integers? Operations means in mathematics, don't go for the other words in English. This is operation in mathematics is, there are four fundamental operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. You know, this is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So what is the meaning of operations of integers? Now we have to take integers. Which are all integers? Zero, positive numbers and negative numbers. We have to take integers and we have to go for the operations. For example, suppose 2 and 3 are the integers. The first operation is addition. What is the meaning of addition? We have to add the numbers. 2 plus 3 is R. Second operation is subtraction. Suppose the number is 2 and 1. Subtract. 2 minus 1 is 1. Suppose the operation is multiplication. Now I choose the set of numbers. Either it is positive numbers or it is negative numbers. No problem. So I will take the number as 4 and minus 2. So what happens when you multiply? 4 2's are 8. This is actually plus I, plus into minus is minus, minus 8. So the last one is division. For example, I will take 25 and 5. What is the meaning of 25 divided by 5? 25 divided by 5 is equal to, how many times 25 goes is 5? 5 times. This is called as operations of integers. Understood? Now, the main concept of this chapter is properties of integers. I'll wrap these points. Properties of integers. Properties. Properties of integers. What is the meaning of properties? There are four properties. The first one is called as closure property. Closure. Closure property. What is the meaning of closure? We have to see the properties one by one under different operations. So the first operation is under addition. What is the meaning of closure property under addition? We need to take two numbers. We need to take any two integers and we have to add it. So suppose the numbers are 1 and 2. If you add 1 plus 2 is equal to how much? 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. Next one. Suppose the number is minus 2 and minus 3. When you add The numbers which we are writing here supposed to be taken from the integers. What is meaning of integers? The numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, dash dash. When you come backwards, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, dash dash. Among these sets, whether it ends with 3, no. There are infinitely numbers. We have no time. Whether it ends with minus 3, no. There are infinitely many numbers. We have no time to write it. Understood? There are infinitely many numbers. For example, can you count the number of stars? Not possible, because there are infinitely many numbers of stars. Isn't it? So, like this, there are infinitely many natural numbers. There are infinitely many whole numbers. There are infinitely many integers also. So, from that set of numbers, you have to choose any two numbers. In first example, I have taken 1 and 2. I did under addition means I added. So, 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. Second example, minus 2 and minus 3. How to add it? The numbers having, both the numbers are having negative signs, then we need to add the numbers 2 plus 3, 5. But you have to put the sign as minus. Why is so? If the sign of the number is positive and positive, then the answer is in terms of positive. Sign of the number is negative and negative, the sign of the answer is negative. If one is positive and the other is negative, then the answer, or if one is negative, other is positive, then the answer. Now what we are doing? We are adding the numbers. We are adding the numbers. Isn't it? We are adding the numbers. So if both number consists of plus, answer will be in plus. If both number consists of minus, answer will be in minus. If one is plus, one is minus, or if one is minus, other is plus, we need to take the greater number sign. Greater number sign. Suppose this is plus 3, I mean like this, plus 3 plus minus 4. In these two, which is the greater number? 4 is the greater number. Isn't it? That time you have to subtract the number and you have to put bigger number sign. If one is plus, other is minus, you have to subtract the number. So if it is minus 2 plus 3, it is 2, it is 3. If one is plus, other is minus, subtract the number, you will get 1. Bigger number sign is plus, no need to use. This basic concept, if you know, you can solve all the examples. So, I have taken 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. Minus 2 plus of minus 3 is equal to minus 5. Suppose 3 and 7 is given. Operation is addition. 3 plus 7 is 10. Now we need to check. In the first example, we got answer as 3. Whether this belongs to the set of integers, means whether 3 comes in this group of numbers. Yes. After operations, you have got the answer as minus 5. Whether minus 5 belongs to the set of integers. Yes. Here we have not written, but it is there here somewhere. Third example, 3 plus 7 is 10. Whether 10 belongs to the set of integers. Yes. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then we can say in general, suppose the two numbers are A and B. We have taken these numbers from where? Integers. After that we have did the operations. A and B we have added. We have got one more number. Let's call it as C. Whether this number belongs to Z? Yes. So we can say closure property under addition is holds good. Or Integer is closer under addition. What you can conclude? What you can conclude? Closure properties holds good for addition, or closure property is you can say like this: it is closed. Integers are closed. Integers are closed under addition. Integers are closed under addition. Understand what I'm saying? These numbers you have taken from integers. What we did? We have added. After that, we have got one more number. This number also belongs to the same set of numbers. Then we can say integers are closed under addition. Understood? Second concept, under subtraction. Under subtraction, or we can say under subtraction, we need to take two numbers and we have to subtract it. 2 minus 3, 2 minus 3 is minus 1. 7 are 4. Let's subtract. 7 minus 4 is 7 minus 4 is 3. Let's take one more number. One more example. 5 minus 8. 5 minus 8 is minus 3. Whether these numbers belong to the set of integers? Yes. Then we can say integers are closed under subtraction. Integers are closed under subtraction. Integers are closed under subtraction. So next one is multiplication. Same procedure. We have to multiply two numbers. Under multiplication, if you multiply two numbers, the numbers are, any numbers you can choose. 1 into 1, 2 are 2. Minus 3 into 7. Minus 3, 7 are minus 21. Whether these numbers belong to the set of integers? Yes. So we can say integers are closer under multiplication. Integers are closer under multiplication. Fourth one, this is third one now. Fourth one, what is that? Under division. Under division. So here you should be very careful. What is that? Division. We have to divide two numbers. So there, we have to divide two numbers. Division, we have to divide two numbers. Which are the numbers? 1 divided by 2. What is the value of 1 by 2? 1 by 2 means half. Suppose if it is 4 by 2, then we will get 2. Suppose if it is 8 by 4, then we will get 2. Isn't it? Suppose if it is 1 divided by 0, this much time we have not taken 0, isn't it? 0 also we can take it here. 1 by 0 is 1 by 0. You know the, whether you know the value of 1 by 0? So, same. 0 divided by 1 is equal to 0 by 1. 0 by 2 is equal to 0 by 2 is equal to 0 by 3 is equal to, what is the value? When we divide any number to 0, the answer is 0. When we divide any number to 0, answer is 0. When we divide any number to 0, the answer is 0. Whereas here, if you divide 0 to the given number, then it is not 0. It is called as infinity. What? infinity, it is called as infinity, or we will say it is not defined. What? 1 by 0 is not defined. 0 by 1 is 1, sorry, 0. 1 by 0 is not defined. So this is it, closure property. Like this, we have to go. What? Next property. Commutative. What is? The next property is called as commutative property. Commutative property. Commutative. Are the catchable points? Commutative property. Here also, under addition, you have to go for four operations. Under addition. What is under addition? We have to add the numbers. Isn't it? So, 1 plus 2 is equal to how much? 1 plus 2 is equal to how much? 3. If you reverse the number, 2 plus 1 is equal to how much? It is also 3. Isn't it? 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. So what about minus 1 plus 2? Minus 1 plus 2 is equal to 1. What about 2 minus 1? That is also equal to 1. So we can say 1 plus 2 is equal to 2 plus 1. Here we can say minus 1 plus 2 is equal to 2 minus 1, because the values are same. In general, you take A plus B is equal to B plus A. What? A plus B is equal to B plus A. If it is so, we have to take two numbers, we have to add. If these two values are same, then if A plus B is equal to B plus A, then we will say it is a integers are commutative. Integers are commutative over addition. Got it? Integers are commutative over addition. Let's see the subtraction. Anyone can say subtraction. So what is the meaning of subtraction? We have to subtract the given numbers. So the numbers are 2 and 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. The number 192. 1 minus 2 is commutative property under subtraction. Here we need to take two numbers and you have to subtract the numbers. So let us see the examples. 3 and 2. When you subtract 3 and 2, we will get 1. Again, change the reverse the numbers and subtract it. 2 minus 3. What about 2 minus 3? Minus 1. As I said, if 1 is plus, other is minus. If 1 is plus, other is minus, subtract the number and write the bigger number sign. So whether these two values are equal? No. If need, take one more example. 3 and 5, 5 and 3. 3 minus 5 is minus 2. 5 minus 3 is 2. Whether these two values are equal? No. This is positive value, this is negative value. This is positive, this is negative. So, what we can say? A minus B and B minus A are not equal. So we can conclude, we can say integers are not commutative under subtraction. Integers are not commutative under subtraction. Let's go to the next property, under multiplication. So what we need to do, we have to multiply the numbers. Which are the numbers?
you have to take the integers. So 1 into 2, how much? 2. Reverse the numbers and multiply, it is 2. Minus 2 into 5, minus 2 into 5, minus 10, 2 5s are 10, plus into minus is minus. Then 5 into minus 2, it is also 2 5s are 10, plus into minus is minus. Whether these two values are equal? Whether these two values are equal? Yes. So what you can say? Integers are commutative over multiplication. Integers are commutative over multiplication. Means this property holds good. Not only for these values, you can take any values, it satisfies. So it is called as integers are commutative under multiplication. Last one is division. So what is that? What is division? A into B. A divided by B. 1 by 2, what is the value? 1 by 2 we can write as it is. 2 by 1, we can write 2 by 1. What is meaning of 2 by 1? 2 by 1 means 2. 3 by 1 is 3. 4 by 1 means 4. 5 by 1 is 5. So 2 by 1 is 2. This is 1 by 2, this is 2. Whether these two are equal? No. So, these values are not equal. So we can say, watch, if need, let's take one more. 5 divided by 10, this is equal to 5 by 10, this is equal to 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10 by 5, that is equal to 10 divided by 5, 5 ones are 5 twos are, that is 2. See, this time you are getting different answers. These answers are not equal. Suppose the numbers are A and B, when you divide A by B, when you divide B by A are not equal. So you can conclude, integers are not commutative under division. So can I say what is the value of 1 by 0? 1 by 0 is equal to 5. You know this, 0 by 1, 0 by 1 is equal to, how much? 0. If you divide any number by 0, you will get 0. So what about this, whether these two are same? No, because we said A by B and B by A are not equal. So 1 by 0 and 0 by 1 are not equal. 0 by 1 is 0, whereas 1 by 0 is not equal to 0, it is called as not defined. What? Not defined. 1 by 0 cannot be defined. 2 by 0 cannot be defined. 3 by 0 cannot be defined. Understood? So let's go to the next one, associative property. Associative, third one. So what is the meaning of associative property? Here we need to take a associative means three numbers. Let us take A, B and C are 1, 2, 3. We need to add under addition. So first is under addition. 1 plus 2 plus 3. Again I will write same number C. 1 plus 2 plus 3. But I will use now bracket is for last two, here bracket is for first two. Whether the answers are equal, we need to check. 1 you can write as it is plus, 2 plus 3 is 5, that is equal to 6. 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 3, 3 plus 3 is 6. Whether these two are equal? Yes. If we need to take one more. Minus 2, minus 3, and 5.
what is the operation under addition, isn't it? So same value you have to take minus 2, minus 3 and 5, you have to add, but bracket is for plus 2. So why I am using these numbers? Because we are doing the operation for different properties of integers. So these numbers are all integers. So minus 2 we can keep as it is, plus minus 3 plus 4 is plus 2. This is equal. Minus 2 minus 3 is minus 5. What it means? Plus 5. Can you see the answer? Guess them. Minus 2 plus 2 is 0. Minus 5 plus 5 is also 0. These two are equal. What you can conclude? Integers are associative under addition. Associative property holds good for addition of integers. Associative property holds good for addition of integers. So the next one is what? Under subtraction. So associative property under addition you can write it as a plus b plus c is equal to a plus b plus c. Now if it is minus, a minus b minus c is equal to a minus b minus c. We need to check for this. That is called as what? Subtraction. Subtraction. We need to check. Suppose the example is 1, you have taken the number as 1, 2 and 3. 1 minus 2 minus 3. 1 minus 2 minus 3. Bracket is for first. Bracket is for you. Bracket is for last two. Here bracket is for first two. What is the value? 1 you can keep as it is. Minus as it is. First simplify the numbers in second brackets. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. As I said, 1 is plus, 1 is minus. Subtract the number. Bigger number sign in place. Here 1 minus 2. Again, 2 minus 1. 1 minus 2. Bigger number is 2. Isn't it? So 1 minus 2 means 1 is plus, other is minus. Subtract the number. 2 minus 1 is 1. Keep bigger number sign. Minus 3 as it is. That's equal to 1. Minus into minus plus 1. This is equal to, if both are minus, add the number, place minus as it is. 1 plus 1 is 2. Whether these two values are equal? No. So we can conclude what? Integers are not associative under subtraction. Next one is multiplication. How to do multiplication? Multiplying the numbers 1 into 2 into 3. 1 into 2 into 3. For the last two brackets, for the first two brackets. 1 to keep as it is, 2 3s are 6, 1 2s are 2 into 3. 1 6 are 6, 2 3s are 6. Whether these two are equal? Yes. Whenever we do the operation under multiplication, it holds good for any numbers. So we can say directly, integers are associative under multiplication. We can write it as a into b into c is equal to a into b into c. What about division? Division does not holds good. Why? 1 divided by 2 divided by 3. 1 divided by 2 divided by 3. That's equal. 1 divided by 2 by 3 can be written like this. This is equal to 1. In the place of division, if I use multiplication, 2 by 3 becomes 3 by 3. That is equal to 1 3 is 3 divided by 2. 1 by 2, we can write as it is 1 by, divided by 3, that is equal to 1 by 2 instead of division, if we use multiplication, 3 can be written as 1 by 3. That is equal to 1 1s are 1, 2 3s are 6. Can you see whether these two are equal? No. So, what you can conclude? Integers are not associative under what? Division. Isn't it? Under division. These are the main three properties. Other than this, one more property we have to go on is distributive property. What do you mean by distributive? Now, two operations comes once at a time. Distributive property. What do you mean by distributive property? See, 1 into 2 plus 3. 1 into 2 plus 3. We can write this. You know this is 1 into 2 plus 3 is 5. 1 5 is 5. Same thing can be written as 1 into 2 plus 3. Nothing but we need to multiply 1 into 2 plus 1 with 3. Understood? 1 with 2 as well as 1 with 3. That is the procedure of multiplying. 1 2 is 2 plus 1 3 is 3. That also is equal to 5. So, A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. Understood? This is called distributive property of integers under addition over multiplication. Distributive property of integers under addition over multiplication. What about 1 into 2 minus 3? 1 into 2 minus 3. How we can write? So that is equal to 1 into 2 minus 3 is minus 1. This is equal to minus 1. A into B minus C is equal to A into B minus A into C. Do you agree with this? This is called distributive property of subtraction over multiplication. Distributive property of subtraction over multiplication. So this is one of the properties. By using this, we can solve the problem. Understood? Suppose number is 1 into 2 plus 3. Either we can multiply 1 into 2 plus 3 is 5 directly, or 1 into 2 plus 3 means we need to multiply 1 with 2 plus 1 with 3. That's also 2 plus 3. That's also 5. This part is what? Distributive property. What about division? Division, how we can say division? Division does not work good. For that, I have given one examples. Check whether A divided by B plus C is equal to A divided by B plus A divided by C. Like this problem I have given. For example, value of A is 12. Value of B is minus 4. And value of C is 2. What happens? So, 12 divided by minus 4 plus 2. What is the value? Similar, 12 divided by 4 is equal to A divided by C. 12 divided by this one is minus 4. This is 2. Let's see. 12 divided by minus 4 plus 2 is minus 2. This is equal to what? 12 by minus 2, that is minus 6. Okay. 12 divided by minus 4 is minus 3. 12 by 2 is 6. When you add these two, minus 3 plus 6, you will get
3. Whether 3 and minus 6 are equal? No. So directly we can see integers are not integers does not follow distributive property rules. Also we have seen how to add in integers on a number line, how to subtract the integers on a number line, how to multiply integers on a number line. Other than that, what is additive identity of an integer? So what is meaning of additive identity? I have given a formula, a plus 0 is equal to a. What is the meaning of this? To get the answer as the given number, what we have to add? To get answer as the given number, what we need to add? When we will get 3 as the answer? When? If the number is 3, when we add 0, then we will get 3. What we have added here? 0. So, to get the answer as the given number, what we need to add is called as additive identity. Additive identity of integer is additive identity for integer is 0. The last one is multiplicative identity. What is the meaning of multiplicative identity? To get answer as the given number, what we need to multiply? What we need to multiply, that number is called as multiplicative identity. So, 1 is called as multiplicative identity. In general, we will say A into 1 is equal to A, or A into 1 is equal to 1 into A is equal to A. Isn't it? So, multiplicative identity is how much? Multiplicative identity is 1. Last one, reciprocal. What is the reciprocal of a given number? Reciprocal of a given number is the 1 by of the given number. Suppose 1 is the given number, what is the reciprocal of 1? Reciprocal of 1 is 1 by 1. 2 is the given number, what is the reciprocal of 2? 1 by 2 is the given number. 3 is the given number, what is its reciprocal? 1 by of that number. So, reciprocal of 4 is 1 by 4. Reciprocal of A is 1 by A. What is the meaning? What is the meaning of that? To get 1 as the answer, what we need to multiply? To get 1 as the answer, what we need to multiply? That is called its reciprocal. Or, A into 1 by A is equal to, A get the answer is 1. Why have taken this 1 by 3? Near cancels. Why have taken 1 by 2? You get cancels. 1 as the answer, what a 1 as the answer, what you need to multiply is called the reciprocal of the given number. So, almost I have revised all the concept. I feel it's helpful for your revision as well as SA1 examination. So, when school starts, again I will try to explain clearly. With a short span of time, it is difficult to cover all the concept. So, I hope you all understood and make use of this video. Once again, this is the chapter Integers going to be for your SA1 examination. One more chapter is there. If it is possible, I will try to cover in the next session. Thank you.